a company now. We have Mr. V. Kalyan Rama, the CMD of Container Corporation, who joins in now. Hi, sir. Thanks very much for taking the time out. You know, there is a Nomura report, which has in fact come out this week, and they've spoken about how the railways have cut haulage charges for empty containers and empty wagons by 25%. And that is expected to be a big positive for a company such as yours in terms of cost savings as well. Can you just tell us what exactly this means financially for the company?
Morning. Yes, the empty haulage rates have been reduced by 25%. And this definitely will be a good positive thing for empty repositioning back to the ports. Because India, we are a little import-heavy country. And a lot of empty repositioning happens from India back to various loading locations across the seas. So instead of, and also this increased hinterland penetration. More and more containers will come to ICDs instead of the shipping lines forcing the customers to destuff the container at the port itself. And we are expecting a positive gain in this. But just it is going to start from 1st of January. And normally we don't do our price hike directly relational to these things. We do our pricing as per the market conditions. But this will be a definite positive factor for improving the volumes.
Good morning, Mr. Rama. Prashant here. This, essentially, this is haulage charged by the Indian Railways, right? Which you pay to the railways.
Yes.
Right? Namira's got some numbers. They're saying that, you incurred about 122 odd crores in the first half as costs towards empty wagons, towards empty haulage. So, and there's a 25%. Go on, sir.
No, Prashant, see, this empty haulage includes, it's empty wagon and empty containers.
Mm.
So, this empty, even though there's a 25% cut, sometimes it may not directly proportional in the reduction on that. So, we are already doing some circuits at some concessional rates. So, we have to work out. See, these numbers, let us not put direct proportion to that.
Okay. No, but if we just absolutely agree with you, sir, so operationally things do differ in terms of what you decide from time to time.
Yes.
But if one just takes the first half numbers, just ballpark, not being exact, 122 crores was what the cost incurred towards this was for the first half. Full year is about 250. 25% cost saving means there's about a 50-60 odd crores savings. In the ballpark, would that number be correct?
Yeah. Yeah, that's correct. Yes, there will be around 50-60 crore savings. So, these savings, we may pass on certain things to the customers because, you see, when we do that price adjustments, what we are expecting is increase in volumes and increase in the rail share. See, this exercise is to increase the rail share, just not to save that money to the company.
Okay.
So, that's why I'm telling it's not direct proportional. Direct proportional, it will increase the volumes.
Okay, just coming.
So there will be more benefit. Actually, it will be more. Let me complete this. See, instead of the direct reduction and then savings to the company, it will be more beneficial because more volumes will come onto the rail. And we are predominantly rail-based movement company, so 94% is by rail.
Okay.
Would you have the leeway to keep some of these gains? So, I mean, annually, the profits for Container Corp are about 1,000 odd crores or so, roughly. This would be about 5% as a proportion of the annual profits. Would you have the leeway to keep some of this, or in the current market, you'd feel inclined to pass all these savings to customers?
You see, I will answer this way. Our pricing is based on market, so what we can keep it, but instead of, we will try to gain more market share. If I can gain at least, if suppose 10% more market to the rail coefficient, that will be more beneficial rather than just keeping it. So, I think you got my point.
Okay. So, just come in on the volumes then, sir. Your guidance was around 10 to 12% in terms of volume growth for FY19. What exactly is volumes done in first half, and what are you anticipating for the second half?
You see, first off, we achieved almost the guidance figure. Our volume growth in handling volumes is roughly around 11 to 12%. So I just don't remember exactly the number. But things are good. Because of elections, maybe there may be some sort of cautious approach by the importers, exporters. Otherwise, we are keeping our guidance as it is.
So generally during election year, you see lesser amount of volume movement?
Maybe. I'm not sure. Let me see this time. Because last time during the election, it was less. But once the government formed, there was a bumper import into the country. So whether the same trend will continue now or we are going with the normal volumes, because the economy is doing well. So I think there is not much of worry on that.
Okay. You've also managed to take two successive price hikes, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, we started charging for the services we were offering. So that was not actually railway freight hike. We are charging around 1500 rupees per TU because for the services which we were providing for last 2 years. And now those services were very well set in and the customers are enjoying the benefits of it. Because that is a cost to us, we are collecting the cost now. We had a price hike in month of May, around 1000 rupees per TU. And this particular price hike, what has been done by the railways, we did not pass on that. Because we are able to maintain our margin, so we are maintaining our price as it is for the time being.
Mr. Rama, just to stick with that point, oil prices have come off recently and sharply, right?
Yeah.
Will trucks as a mode of transportation vis-a-vis rail have some advantage incrementally? Are you seeing some volumes move onto roads and trucks? Because you've increased prices and oil prices have gone down, which is beneficial for road transport.
Yeah, the point is very well. You have taken a correct point. See, that's where the competition is, road. That's why this price hike has been, whatever the 5% price hike done by railways, we did not do that price hike. We just maintained our prices. Because the road is little softened than the price side. But as such, the volumes did not move onto the road. We are having our volumes and we are seeing the demand.
Okay. Volumes, you had guided for between 12 and 14% volume growth for FY19, Mr. Rama. You track on track for that?
Yeah. Yes, we are on track for that. Absolutely no problem.
Okay. And
also good demand. We'll...
Any indication for FY20 or it's too early?
It's too early. Let me complete FY19-20, then I will 18-19, then I'll speak about 19-20.
Okay, Mr. Rama, just last point. CAPEX at Container Corporation over the last couple of years has been quite heavy. I mean, it's been 700-800 crores or so. Could you tell us what is the thinking going forward? Where could that settle at?
Yeah, we normally work on a 5-year block period. So this year also we are doing around 800 to 1000 crores. And for the 5-year block from 17 to 22, we are aiming at doing 6 crores. Because we are entering into a new field, that is 3PL logistics, distribution logistics. So it's not completely invested by us, but with partnerships. So there will be a lot of private capital also coming along with our capital. So it's 8,000 will be from our side in 5 years, but there will be equal amount or maybe little more from the partners coming into this.
So who are your partners?
In next 5 years from our side, we will be selecting through expression of interest.
Okay.
Already for one in Chennai distribution center, we already floated our expression of interest.
And when will this be finalized by? I mean, right now it's in an EOI state, but when will we probably hear the partners being finalized?
1 month's time. First partner for one center, so we are starting such centers, 20 centers across India. So every center will be given a EOI and in open competition we will be selecting the partners who got the experience in this distribution logistics.
Mr. Rama, again, sorry, last question, but any update on the dedicated freight corridor?
whenever we have the opportunity to talk with you, we ask you this question, much awaited by investors when they look at your company and they wonder what earnings will look like once DFC is a reality. Any thoughts, sir?
Yeah, see, now there is, I think, little more emphasis on DFC completion and the target. Whatever is DFC is talking of, I will officially go by that, and I expect that things will happen. By next year end, we will be able to see some positive results in our balance sheets from the DFC operations.
Mr. Rama, thank you very
for that.
Thanks very much, sir. Appreciate you joining in. Great speaking with you. And thank you for your time today on CNBC-TV18. Thanks indeed.